of acts. It cleanses our conscience of acts that will surely kill you. Because you know what he says? If you keep trying to deal with that external stuff on your own and don't deal with the inside, you're going to end up destroying yourself. There are a lot of folk in the grave now because they could never deal with their guilty conscience. And they created acts. They did stuff that cost them their lives. Not only did God clean us up on the inside so that we have a clean conscience, so we no longer have to walk around with that guilt and that shame. We no longer have to walk around with those burdens. We no longer have to walk around with the mistakes of our past. We no longer have to worry about what the devil throws up in our face, about how we used to live and how we used to go. That's why I like that song. That's why I like that song that we said before. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Since I laid my burdens down, and I don't know about nobody else, but I feel better. I feel so much better. To have an attitude of gratitude. I don't know about you, but I'm thankful for what the Lord done for me. Yes, I can dance like that choir, like the praise dancer. When I look back over my life and I think things over, I can truly say that I've been blessed. I got me a testimony. Now I can serve. A good Lord. Now I can tell you, God, I thank you for what you've done for me. And I can say, Lord, I thank you where you brought me from. I can say, Lord, I thank you in spite of what I was. I thank you that you forgave me and gave me another chance.
You can call me a mediator. A new covenant. He became the go-between between he negotiated this deal. Between God above, man below. Notice what the text says, verse 15. This right for this reason, Christ is the mediator of the new covenant. To that those who are called, notice. We've received the promised inheritance. Now that he has died as a ransom. He has died as a ransom. He has died as a ransom. And you know why he died? To set me free. Yes, that songwriter is right. I am free. No longer bound. No more chains holding me. Can I get a witness here? My soul is resting. It's just a blessing. Hallelujah! Satan had me back. But Jesus lifted me. Yes, 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 yes. And I'm so yes, he had to die in order for this new covenant to come into existence. Verse 16, notice he had to die. Because notice, verse 17, because the will is enforced, somebody had to die. There had to be some blood that was shed. Notice that's why even the first covenant that was made. It was not put in effect. It was not put in effect. Even the first covenant that was made, it was not put into effect unless there was some blood. Verse 19, Moses had proclaimed, notice, every command of the law to all the people. But you know what he had to do after he proclaimed the law? He took the blood of calves together with water and scarlet wood and branches of hyssop and sprinkled a scroll over all the people. That this is the blood of the covenant which God has commanded you to keep in the same way. He sprinkled the blood both on the tabernacle and everything that was used in the ceremony in the law. It was required that everything had to be clean with blood, because without the shedding of blood, without the shedding of blood, without the shedding of blood, yes, yes, that God will provide us a better sacrifice. Oh, yes, oh, yes. The Old Testament, blood had to cover everything in order to be holy. Folk had to sacrifice using the blood. Yes, they still had to walk around with that guilt and that shame. You know what? He says, God has provided us a better way. Yes, yes, yes. For Christ, verse 24, did not enter a sanctuary that was made with human hands, because that was only a copy of the real sanctuary, the one that was in heaven. And now, He appears now. He appears for us in God's presence. Now he appears for us to give us forgiveness. Now he appears for us as our advocate. Now he appears for us as our mediator. Now he appears for us, the one that has died for me. Now he appears for us, the one that is able to cover my sin. Now he appears for us, the one that washes my sins away. Now he appears for us to give is for us. It's our mediator. Verse 24. Now he appears for us. God's presence on my behalf. Notice, I'm so glad. Because see, in the Old Testament, you know what would happen? Every year, the high priest had to go into that most holy place. Every year, that priest had to offer a sacrifice for his own sins. And then he would have to offer one for the sins of the people. Verse 25, nor did he enter the heaven. Yes, not did he enter that heavenly holy of holies. No, he didn't enter heaven to offer that for himself again and again. Notice the way the priest in the Old Testament had to enter the most holy place every year with the blood that was not his own. Yes, otherwise, Christ would have had to suffer many times. He would have had to die many times. There would have had to have been a whole lot of Good Fridays. Yes, 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 yes. Every year he would have had to die again in order to have my sins forgiven. Yes, yes, he would have had to die many times since the creation of the world. But you know what the text says? He has appeared. Yes, he has died once for all. Yes, with the culmination of the age to do away with sin. Yes, yes, and you know what? In the Old Testament, after they offered the sacrifice, they still had to deal with their sin.
because their sins were only covered. But when Jesus died, it was the Lamb of God not covered our sin. But the Bible says, behold the Lamb of God. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold the Lamb of God that takes away.
Never to bring them up again. Yes, yes. He says, you can get ready now. You don't have to worry about the guilt and the shame no more. Yes, that which needed to be sacrificed has already been sacrificed. Yes, you don't have to walk around with your head hung low. Yes, because Christ sacrificed himself. Yes, and because Christ sacrificed himself, it saved me from having to face the judgment. Yes, it faced me having to go on the slippery sliding board to hell. Yes, because Christ sacrificed himself. Yes, he is able to lift us up out of the muck and the miry clay. Yes, because he sacrificed himself. Yes, we just sing like the songwriter, I'm so glad that Jesus lifted me. Yes, because see, one day I was going to have to face the judgment. One of these days I was going to have to face my Savior. Yes, but you see, I ain't got to go with him with fear and trepidation. Yes, I ain't got to go with him with my head hung down. I don't have to worry about going to stand before my Maker with all the guilt and the shame of my past, because Jesus paid it all, and all to him I owe. Yes, yes, one day we got to face the judgment, but the good news, Christ was sacrificed once and for all to take away the sins of men. And so you know why I ain't got to worry about anything. You know why I ain't got to worry about the guilt and the shame of my past. You know why I ain't got to worry about when I see Jesus, what he's going to say to me. Because the blood still works. Yes, in one of these old days, when I go before my Maker and I got to stand before him, I know I messed up. I know I've got a past. I know I've gone places that I shouldn't have gone. Shouldn't have said, but I'm so glad that the blood still works. Every day I can wake up not worried about the guilt of yesterday. I can wake up with new mercies, because great is God's faithfulness, because he died in order to give me the right to eternal life and the blood. It reaches the highest mountains. Yes, that blood still flows to the lowest valleys. It's the blood that gives me strength from day to day. Shall never lose his power. Yes, yes, and he's coming back again. Not to die again. Bring salvation. Those who've been waiting on him. You know what he says in light of all that God has done for us? We've got something better to look forward to. Yes, yes. So you don't have to walk around with the guilt of your past. You don't have to walk around with that shame. You don't have to walk around with your head hung low. You don't have to self-medicate, smoking and drinking, thinking that's going to solve your problems. All you got to do is come to Jesus just as you are. And when you come to him just as you are, he takes away the sins of your past. And the reason why he's able to do that, the reason why he's able to forgive you, the reason why he's able to wash all your sins away is because the blood
still work.